So let's see what we can test here. What do we have in the back? The rocket! Hi, welcome to Beernet Skate Systems. Today we're going to do a review about one of the highest quality longboards that you can get, the Rocket Exodus. The Rocket longboards are made in the Swiss Alps. They deliver the highest quality possible, and that is what you can see on their decks. Innovation is one of their main goals when they develop new shapes for their longboards. One of the latest innovations that they also use in this Exodus is the LAF technology. LAF stands for light as. This technology uses a wooden core sandwiched between carbon and glass fiber. Has a few advantages. One of it is that it's very light, it's very durable, and the best thing is they finish it with a urethane edge which makes it 100% waterproof. You can see that the nose and the tail is designed to fit all the brackets that are available on the market, such as the Super Duper Fork from G-Bomb and the Torsion Tail also from G-Bomb. And that's what we are going to use with the review of the Rocket Exodus. As a front bracket, I'm going to use the G-Bomb Super Duper Fork. I used it already before in one of my reviews, so I don't have to explain a lot about it. It's made out of aluminium, very durable. It has a built-in wedge, as you can see, of 12 degrees, and it's designed to fit all the trucks that are available. As a back truck, I'm going to use the TTS from G-Bomb, the Torsion Tail Steel. This one is the normal, the older design. They have also a design which is slightly slimmer. The TTS W's has the green 75A cubes from Riptide and the purple Tall Cones 70A from Riptide. As a front truck, I will use again the Don't Trip Poppy. This one is brand new, 45 degree base plate angle, and it comes with a spherical in the pivot. It's a very good truck, one of the best that you can get for LDP. The spherical in the pivot means that there is slightly less resistance when steering it, although there is more vibrations, so the comfort is a bit lower. We will see how it will go with the Don't Trip Poppy. The wheels that I will use are again from Seismic, the Seismic Alpha. These ones are the 80.5mm and 55mm wide. It's called the LDP trim. They are designed for long distance pushing, long distance pumping. Let's build this Rocket Exodus. And this is how it looks like when it's built. It looks really nice. What I also noticed is that there's a 3D shape in the deck. There's some spaces here to mount the brackets on the front and also on the back. But there's also a rocker, camber and a rocker shape. Don't know if you can see it on the video, but it's definitely worth a try. There's also a nice tub concave here on the edges. And also in the back, and you can see with the shape of the deck that there is nice placement for your foot. I also mounted the PSD Riptide footstop. This one is the outside one. Before you go skating, always check for wheel bite on the front wheels. What I did, I checked it and I wasn't completely sure because of the wheels. They are not so wide, but the core inside is placed differently, and therefore I increased the width of the poppy with 6mm. That means that there's now a total width of 131mm. When I mounted this deck, I had a really good look at the shape here, the urethane on the sides. It looks really nice, really high quality. I think I really will like this deck. Let's go for a skate. So the first kilometers, let's see how it will go. So the weather is great and I found a quiet road to do some skating outside of the city center. Not a lot of people here. Got the road almost for myself. Because of the coronavirus, I want to do the social distancing. And in the city, still a lot of people go out with this nice weather. And I want to stay away from other people, so that's why I went here. First feeling, pumps really nice. Especially in the front and in the back, there's enough rebound to get an easy pumping. It's of course due to the torsion tail here in the back. A slightly wheel lift. Didn't expect that with the 70A bushings, but look at the shadows, maybe you can see it, but it feels really good. The placement of your feet is really good at this deck. The concave is nice, it's a top concave. The sides are a little bit higher, like in a bathtub maybe. But it feels good, really comfortable. Your feet are positioned in the concaves of the deck. You can see it here. Closer to each other. The deck is slightly thicker. It's a little firm. There's not a lot of flex in there. This is the flex 2. And that's for the let's say the medium flex. And there is now a Rocket Exodus Plus. And the Plus is really for the more heavier skaters among us. Thickness, it's a bit higher. Seismic Alphas, they have a different offset than the speed fence, and therefore wheel bite is possible. Yeah, they come up to speed quickly. They don't have a lot of roll resistance, especially these ones, the 78, the Mint Urethane. I think with the 76, the Mango version, that they are more comfortable. That's what I would use for all my distances that I do on different days, commuting to work, etc. Pumping goes really nice. There's of course the TTS in the back, and the TTS makes it that it's pumping. It's with a lot of rebound, the steel that is giving the torsion back and propels into speed. Yeah, I don't have to pump really hard to maintain a nice speed. I can do small pumps. I can also do the bigger pumps. With the TTS, overall, I like the smaller pumps. There's nothing bad to say about the puppy. It's good that you can change the width of the... Oh, some stones. It's good that you can change the width of the axle. There are three or four different axle width that you can position the wheels on. Great, great front truck. Yeah, it looks good. This one with the spherical pivot. Feels really nice. There's maybe some more vibration, some more noise, but on a road like this, who cares?
Time for the BNet score. We will start with the race score and the first category, pushability. Pushing is really good, therefore I'll give it a 9. Next, the pumpability is also really good, even better than before. A 10. The weight 3595 grams, a 9. All the components that I used are really high quality, therefore this is the 10.
all these high quality components together makes it that the race handling is a 10. That will give a total race score 48 out of 50, which is the highest score that I ever did on a peanut score. Next up, fun score. And I'll start with the comfort. Good wheels, a bit hard, firm flex, only a 5. Slow pump cruise, all the components are not so good for slow pump, therefore only a 4. It's easy to bring this deck to a race, but I wouldn't do your groceries with it, practicality only a 3. For racing and all the other things you can have a lot of fun, therefore this is a 7. Value, it's quite expensive, but still very good value, also a 7. This will bring the fun score to a total of 26. 26 is a really low fun score, but still 74 for the Beernut score. And that is the highest Beernut score until now. This setup with all these nice components is now available in my webshop for a reduced price. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hope to see you in my next video with the Subsonic Illuminati.